Hello and welcome to the Business Today Show. I'm your host, Udayan Mukherjee. If you ever found yourself in a really tight corner and you wanted someone from the Indian business sector to bat for your life, that would be my guest today because he's the quintessential fighter. Over the decades, he's overcome challenge after challenge to emerge as one of the most successful entrepreneurs of this generation. It gives me great pleasure to welcome Sunil Bharti Mittal to the Business Today Show. Sunil, welcome and great to see you again.
Nice to see you too.
As I was saying, you know, I often keep thinking that, you know, if you were not in telecom, you would be a boxer or a wrestler. You know, I mean, that fighting spirit, where did you get it from?
No, I think it comes out as, you know, perhaps we are fighting all the time. And it looks like we are surviving. I mean, cycles have been such in our industry that one had to deftly maneuver the surroundings, the markets, the technologies. But, well, I would say it's been a great effort of the team that we have been able to pull together each time when we were faced with adversities of proportions that are perhaps rarely seen in an entrepreneur's life. You do your business, you know, you fight in the market, you lose market share, you gain market share, profits go up or down. But the life of Airtel has been very challenging, to say the least. And I'm glad that we are here today, much stronger, much sharper in our focus towards the customers, and a reasonably healthy balance sheet.
Well, you have come up on top, but on a bad day, do you sometimes still feel that, you know, I could have chosen any sector and made a success of it? Why did I end up choosing telecom? Because, you know, it seems like the challenges never go away.
It is true. But I think it'll be seen when you kind of reflect back, a life well lived, you know. I mean, I guess everybody's dealt, you know, certain cards, and all we can do is make the most of what has been dealt to us. I mean, I came into telecommunications way back in 1982, when it was unheard of private sector being in the telecom sector. It was a domain and really a bastion of public sector units, ITI factories producing equipment, and you know, Department of Telecommunications running fixed line services. Phones were a rarity. If you got a phone out of turn, that was a great deal of celebration. So I've really walked this journey right from the early days of telecom reforms. And this is what I've learned, and this is what I stuck with. I mean, we have done other businesses, but this has really been the mainstay.
And has it changed for the better after the recent relief package that we saw from the government, which you were rooting for as well? Or do you think it's only delayed the inevitable, which is the formation of a duopoly for the sector between you and Reliance?
Well, you know, the Prime Minister said something very importantly, that this is a decisive government. And I think nothing demonstrates this more than the recent telecom package that has been unveiled. You require a very strong leader, you require a very strong and stable government to deal with a black swan event like the one India faced. We are 1.3 billion people. And we were staring at the prospect of India going down to two private sector operators. I think that would have been very bad for outcome for the country. And I'm glad that this package was unveiled. And really, there were two pillars of this package. One was administrative reforms, which we have been trying to get attention for the last 20, 25 years. There were issues like storing CAF forms in paper form in warehouses. Airtel had 16 warehouses around the country, regular audits of papers, rats eating up those papers. I mean, we have went back and again, but never got the attention. So items like those, very small C-class items, have gone away. Bank guarantees have been rationalized. KYC issues have been rationalized. So a lot of, I would say, administrative reforms, which were in the area of ease of doing business, have been done, and they must be lauded. The second part was the financial side. There is an industry player which is not in a position to pay up the government dues and stress on the other dues of banks and markets, and something needed to be done. And I think the government came up with a very strong, big package of moratorium, and also the interest on that period of moratorium to be offered as an equity is, I would say, a rare event to save our industry, which is vital for the future of our country. So I would say we should all celebrate what has happened here. certainly I personally take a lot of comfort in the way government has moved and moved very quickly to save this sector from near duopoly, if I may say. So great deal of celebration. Will this now completely solve for the problem? Perhaps not. A few more steps are necessary, and I was very heartened to hear the telecom minister mention that this will be seen as the first round of reforms, and there are more to come. So we remain hopeful.